Good morning, John. So as you may have noticed, 3D movies are all the rage. And when I say rage, in some cases I mean actual, physical, literal
rage.
I mean, really, isn't there enough 3D in our lives already? Almost everything I have ever known has been three-dimensional. Seeing a movie in 2D, that just seems like a novelty to me. A little bit of a change. It's refreshing.
Okay. I actually do like 3D movies, and I like to go see them with my wife, because I like to go see all movies with my wife. Because that's just the kind of couple that we are.
And so a little while ago when I was like, Catherine, let's go see Tron on opening night, it's gonna be so fun. She was like,
And I didn't get it. Because of course it's not gonna be a great movie, but it's gonna be a good movie, it's gonna be fun.
And Catherine, for the first time, let it slip that she doesn't like 3D movies because they give her a headache. And I was like, what? So I did some research and it turns out that 10% of Americans, that's 30 million people, experience discomfort while watching 3D movies, whether it's nausea, motion sickness, or just a headache. And this was a pretty revolutionary discovery for me.
So what did I do about it?
Well, I dragged Catherine to go see Tron and she watched pirate style for half the movie and still got a headache. But I did not ignore the needs of my better half completely because I know how 3D movies work and I knew that it would be a relatively simple thing to create a pair of glasses that let you watch a 3D movie in 2D. So later that week, I called a company that manufactures 3D glasses.
Yo, can you make glasses with the same polarization in each lens?
Yeah, I mean, we could, but that would totally ruin the 3D effect. By ruin the effect, do you mean that it would be a crisp, clear, two-dimensional image?
Yes.
Excellent. I will take 5,000. I'm not kidding, I actually did it. 2D glasses.
I'm so stylin'!
It's kind of a big deal for me. I had this idea, and then I made it.
I made my idea real.
Catherine has watched several movies with those and with the prototypes, and she says it's wonderful.
And I can't imagine she's just saying that because she's my wife.
And I have to say thanks to all the people who helped make this real. Winnie at the factory, Sam for doing the web development, Karen for design. Tim did a great comic that's up at 2D-glasses.com. My dad, as always, for doing the accounting and legal stuff. And my partner at DFTBA Records, Alan. And also Chris for helping doing the distribution and actually getting them to the people who buy them.
I made a thing!
John, I will see you on Wednesday.
Time for the end screen and frequently asked questions. Question one, where can I buy them? 2D-glasses.com.
Special introductory offer, $7.99 per pair. If you buy two, you save $2.
Will they work with my 3D television?
No, probably not, I'm sorry, but it's a different technology that televisions use.
Will you come on my nationally syndicated talk show and talk about your glasses?
Oh, of course, yeah, absolutely. Though I don't like leaving my house, so... Is it okay if I Skype it in?
How on earth does that work?
Well, there is a whole page at 2D-glasses.com that explains it all to you.
Do I have to buy them online?
Yes, you do, because the internet is where it's at, man.
Are you excited about Portal 2?
Yes, I'm excited about Portal 2. Look, it comes out in like 12 hours. I will be playing it at youtube.com/hankgames.
The channel where I'm currently rushing to finish Portal 1 because I want to finish it before I start Portal 2.
Didn't you forget to thank someone in your thank yous?
Yes, I did. I forgot to thank Victor, who was instrumental in making this whole thing happen.
Why did your lighting change so much to the end screen? Because in between when I filmed these two things, I went to go see Rio in 3D. It was awesome. Beautiful in 3D, but Catherine enjoyed it too, because it was not painful for her.
Because of these.